Good, belly towards your spine. And now we're gonna lower down and come up into what I like to call snake. And then there's this great yoga word for this pose, and I can't remember what it is, but it kind of sounds like a sneeze. It's like asnasanata, ananana.
Anjaneyasana.
Anjaneyasana. Thank you, Mrs. Clemmer.
And you have to make sure you keep your knee over your ankle so you don't damage your patella.
Oh. Do you want to come up and show us?
Okay.
Great. Thank you.
All right. Knee over the ankle, arms up in the air. Anjaneyasana. Warrior two.
Good at this.
It happens. Now that you're free, I was wondering if maybe we could go out sometime.
Go. I don't date my bosses.
Great, because I'm not your boss anymore.
Or my ex-boss.
Let me take your arm.
Oh, what a gentleman. Thank you. So what are we doing tonight?
Tonight, it's dinner at a romantic little spot off the beaten track with the best food in the city.
Sounds great.
Yeah, then tomorrow I was thinking breakfast in the country with my mother. She's very excited to meet you. Are you a size two? Because if you are, her wedding dress would be a perfect fit.
Mike?
Yeah?
You know what? Suddenly I'm not that hungry. But maybe we can take a rain check?
Sure, yeah, absolutely. It's supposed to rain next week.
You're back already. 2 minutes. That is a record even for you.
I may not know what I want, but I know what I don't want.
What is that?
That was the sound of the last time I let you fix me up.
His ex said he was a catch.
Maybe there's a reason she's his ex.
Or maybe there's a reason you don't give anyone or anything a chance.
I give everything a chance.
Really? How was the job at the dental office?
Not...
For you.
I don't like teeth.
You know who that sounds like?
Don't say mom.
Did you read her last postcard? She's in Maine on a hiking trip.
Oh, you're 2 weeks behind. I just saw on her Facebook page that she met a bunch of tourists and she's joining them for a cruise.
Exactly. She can't even commit to a hike.
Well, I can commit. I just haven't found the thing I'm really good at yet. Hey.
Rob, Steve, dinner's ready, okay?
Hey, no, it's my sword.
The dragon again.
But Aunt Poppy, Steve won't give me a sword. It's not my fault you broke yours.
Do you guys hear that?
Hear what?
It's the dragon breathing. Oh. While you two fight over that sword, he's getting closer. Now, you know what's more important than a sword when you're defending yourself against a rogue dragon?
No.
A fireproof shield. Oh. Throw me that pillow. Now, that dragon breathes on you, you are toast. You're worse than toast. You're burnt toast. Now go. Defeat the dragon. Both of you.
Ha, take that in your face,
oh, no.
Dragon. We got
ha,
you
take
now.
That,
ha.
Dragon.
You'll never get up. Hey, we got you now.
Well, you do know I'm never getting that pillow back, right?
Small price to pay for saving the kingdom.
Yes, we did it! We got him!
Yeah! That's awesome.
This is something you're really good at.
This broccoli is really good, Mom. Mm. Mm.
Thank you.
25,000 downloads a day. And if we can land this, that number doubles.
Yeah, I know. I hear what you're saying.
Well, I don't think it's that complicated. We just tell them who we are. You know, we're a young, proven company. We've got apps that work. And this one has a great interface. It's simple. Exactly. Yeah, and I just think we share, like, the comments, you know? It's got... Here, I got it right here.
I gotta call you back.
Oh, sure. Yep.
Can I help you?
Oh, I'm Poppy Summerall. Temporarily for you. Made a business card and everything.
Yes, you're Megan's sister.
And you're Ryan Larson.
Yeah, come on in.
Thank you.
Yeah. Any trouble finding the place?
No, I just looked for the only house on the block without Halloween decorations.
Yeah. Halloween was kind of my wife's thing.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to...
No. It's okay. It's been almost 4 years now. Anyway, thank you for coming. My company's expanding one of our apps, so it's crunch time.
I can crunch.
Great. Well, let me introduce you.
Okay.
Hey, guys, come and meet Poppy.
Do we have to?
She's your new nanny, so yes.
We don't want a new nanny.
Tell them I'm a mermaid.
She's a mermaid.
I told you she's not a real mermaid.
That's Zoe.
Hi, Zoe.
Hello.
And the boy hiding behind his big sister is Zach.
Hello, Zach. You know, I've got a big sister, too. Her kids go to your school.
Sorry. They'll warm right up to you.
That's okay. They must have really liked their last mammy.
Oh, that's a long story. I'm on my way. Okay, we good to go?
Yeah, all nannied up.
Great. I don't usually work Sundays, but this is a crazy week, so emergency numbers are on the fridge. Here are these. And the secret password is Pumpkinhead for now.
Got it.
All right, have a good one.
Yeah, you too.
Thanks.
Hello. This is...
You guys in there?
No.
Can I come in?
What's the password?
Password?
Not even close.
Flippity gibbet. No. Bingo bongo.
No.
I don't. Pumpkinhead?
My dad told you.
Maybe. Or maybe mermaids can read minds.
What am I thinking?
You're thinking, what am I thinking? You guys want to go have some fun?
Be a new inbox record.
Now this is a harvest festival.
If you're a mermaid, then where's your tail?
It only comes out in the ocean.
What do you eat?
Seaweed and algae.
You don't eat fish?
No, fish are my friends.
Do you speak fish?
Fluently, but my French is better. Corn on the cob. Do you know how to pick out corn? So get the ones that are like kind of yellow underneath. Those are the good ones.
What's your favorite food? How many marshmallows can you fit in your mouth at one time? What's the scariest roller coaster you've ever been on and can go swim?
Anything with mustard, 9, drop of doom, only fish ghosts.
What are we gonna do with all this corn?
We're gonna make cornbread.
Yeah, what are we gonna do with that?
We're gonna eat it along with the chili we're gonna make for dinner. Does your dad like chili?
He eats at work. That's why you were with us. So he doesn't have to be.
I bet he wishes he was here.
I hate cornbread. More for me.
And me.
Spider! Spider! Spider!
Let's go.
Zach, where are you going?
Zach?
Zach!
So I think that spiders might like corn on the cob as much as people do. Sorry, buddy. Okay. I'm gonna be right over there if you need me, okay? Right there. Hey, Zoe.
Let me guess. He's not talking to you.
Nope. That's okay. Talking's overrated. I'm gonna talk to these guys. Hey, Nanny. Hi. I'm a nanny, too.
I know why they call it a nanny, though.
Why?
Because nannies come in and try to take over.
My favorite sweater!
No. Okay, off. Roll over.
Spit.
No.
Heel.
This is all your fault. I want to go home.
Me too.
Me three. Well,
you woke me.
Don't worry, it's just a little bit of blood. I'm kidding. It's juice.
So things went well then?
Completely painless.
Don't worry about the rug, please. The kids asleep?
One is. The other's faking. I took them to the Harvest Festival where Zach had an unfortunate arachnid incident, and Zoe's favorite sweater is currently being digested by a goat.
Oh.
They are wonderful kids.
Oh, no.
Funny and unique and engaging.
You're quitting?
I just don't think this is for me.
It's only been one day.
Is that all?
Okay, a long day. But, you know.
The truth is, I'm not actually a nanny.
I know.
I've never done this before, except for with my sister's kids, and they have to be nice to me because we're related. Wait, what?
Your sister told me on the phone the other day.
And you still hired me? You must be really desperate.
No, it's just... Please, can you just hang on a couple more weeks?
What day is today?
Still Sunday.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Look, I get it. Kids are a huge commitment, even when they're not yours.
I can commit. I can commit. Till the end of the month.
What about next month? Thanksgiving.
This month, Halloween.
Perfect. Deal. Great. Thank you.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. Say, do you think you could do like 6 a.m.?
Don't push it. But I'm committing. Committing. Hello, sister.
How did it go?
Don't ask.
Just tell me you didn't quit already.
I didn't quit.
But you're going to.
I told him I would stay till Halloween.
He's a good guy.
He's a workaholic.
And he's cute.
He's my boss.
Temporarily. Come on. How am I supposed to live vicariously through my single sister's dating life if you don't have a dating life?
So what are we going to do about the fact that Ryan's kids don't want me there?
Just be you.
Zach, I didn't do anything.
Yes, you did. No, I didn't.
Dad!
What's the matter, buddy? Can't sleep?
Zoe put a spider in my bed.
Hey, that's not what I said. I said, what if I did?
You said you'd put it in my bed.
No, I said maybe I might.
Guys, come on. Come on. Come up here. Okay, there are absolutely no spiders.
Dad, Mrs. Brower said we all eat 8 spiders in our sleep every year.
I don't want to eat a spider. I don't want to eat 8 spiders. I don't want to go to bed.
I'm sorry, Dad. I'm just saying what I heard. It's a fact.
Thank you. Go to bed. Yeah, that's a big file. Well, I don't want to slow the site down. All right. All right. Well, you know, see what you can do. Get back to me. Hey, tell Higashimoto how excited we are. I gotta run. My breakfast meeting's here. Yep. Bye.
Breakfast meeting, huh?
I wasn't sure you were gonna make it.
Temporarily for you. Plus, I said I would.
Coffee?
Sure, cream, 2 sugars. Hope your coffee making is better than your sandwich making. Yeah. Really know how to butcher a PB&J.
You should see my grilled cheese.
Oh, I think I peeled one of those off my shoe last night.
Yeah. There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Rough night?
Crowded night. Both kids ended up sleeping in my bed.
Impromptu slumber party. Love it.
More like nightmare patrol. Spiders.
My fault.
No, it's standard operating procedure. So you're living with Megan and the boys?
Temporarily.
Yeah. Oh, so you normally live alone?
Normally.
Huh. So you're single temporarily.
That would be correct.
Sorry, I don't mean to pry. It's just you fit well into our test group.
What?
Oh, my app, Food with Friends. So say you're dining alone and you log into our app, you can find other people nearby that are dining alone and don't want to. Boom, you're having food with friends.
Sounds kind of amazing. It's better than food with enemies.
Oh, that's my next app. Anyway, this company, Yamaharo Global, is considering buying us, which would expand us into foreign markets.
Sounds kind of huge.
Yeah, my big presentation for it is next Friday night.
Halloween.
Yes. Yeah, I forgot about that. I don't think the Japanese celebrate it.
Well, we do celebrate it here.
I gotta run.
Here.
What's this?
PB&J made by a professional.
Huh. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
Have a good one.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Yeah. All right.
Zoe, Zach, almost time for school.
Okay. I mean elementary school. I used to love it. My favorite subject was art class and lunch. Who's your art teacher? Boy or girl? My art teacher's name was Miss A. We'll talk later. We'll finish this later. What is... Oh, gross. Hi, you have got to call me back. I literally just sat in a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. These kids hate me, so I don't know what I'm gonna do. Never mind, I just got an idea.
Yep. How was school?
It was okay.
Michael.
I had a great day. I sat on the most delicious peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Miss Green let us watch cartoons after lunch.
I had Miss Green in second grade.
Maybe just the same Miss Green.
What is she, about 100 by now?
No, she's 50. Probably about your age.
You think I'm 50?
Probably 60.
Wow. Okay, guys, little field trip before we go back home. Now listen, I can't lie. There are gonna be spiders, but they're gonna be fun spiders. I promise.
Halloween everything.
Wow.
Pretty cool, huh? Spooky. Well, we're gonna need a cart, but I'm driving.
These masks are really sparkly.
Boom. Oh, hey, this could look cool over the front door.
Are these too?
Yes. Pumpkins and skeleton heads go together like peanut butter and jelly.
I'm gonna find some headstones. Our mom used to decorate for Halloween all the time, and then she got sick.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. It was a long time ago. I don't really remember her, and Zach doesn't either.
I bet you two had a lot of fun together.
Hey, look at these. My friend had these last year. Her pumpkins looked amazing.
Oh, no, we definitely need a pumpkin carving kit. Actually, we need three. Too many pumpkins out there needing faces. Oh, buddy, that's not real. It's not real. It's okay.
I know, but it's so scary.
How about now? Hard to look spooky when you got a wig on your head, huh? Although you've never met my Aunt Eleanor. All right, what else do we need? Everything. Next stop, zombie aisle.
I love zombies! Yay!
Wait, spiders, no, but zombies he loves?
He's complicated.
Miss Morwell's on her way up.
Thank you, Jean.
Do you ever stop working?
Says the woman who sent me 30 emails on her flight back from Tokyo.
Says the man who answered all of those emails in the middle of the night.
Well, I'm efficient.
It's one of your many attributes. So, good news. Higashimoto loved the app. If we nail this presentation, they are all in. And you, my friend, are giving the presentation.
Me? No, not... Look, you're the one who brokered the deal. It should be you.
No, Ryan, you found an amazing way to connect people, and you need to be upfront on this.
Yeah, I think you should be the one who...
Oh, so cute. It's Zoe and Zach, right?
Good memory.
It must be challenging, trying to raise them alone.
You have no idea.
And now, for the first phase of Operation Decoration. Zoe, please take all of this candy into the kitchen. No dipping into the stash, please. All right, guys, organization is key. We need to take everything out and then decide which decorations go where. Bats, rats, and cats to the left, ghosts and ghouls to the right.
This should go here. Put some leaves around that one. It looks spookier.
Okay, Brain Trust, your thoughts?
Drape those like icing on a cake.
A Halloween cake.
Yeah.
Okay, bag of bones coming in. This one needs more skeleton.
That's how Mom used to do the lights.
Sounds like your mom was really good at Halloween.
She was. You were too young to remember, Zach. I saw a picture of her dressed like Cher at the Oscars.
Cher? Wait, do you mean Cher? That is such a good idea for a costume.
Are you dressing up for Halloween?
Of course I am.
That's what?
I'm not gonna tell you. I can't promise it'll be as cool as Cher, but I'm gonna try. Okay, snack time. Who here likes eyeballs?
Me. They aren't real eyeballs, are they?
Maybe they are. Why don't you taste them? Tell me. Does it taste like an eyeball?
Yeah.
So you like eyeballs, mm-hmm. huh? Are they your favorite food?
Yeah.
Yeah, you like them. What? Thanks for drying. Even though I know it's a ploy to stay up later.
How do you know?
Because you have a dishwasher, smarty pants.
Hey, I just want to see my dad's face when he sees all the decorations.
I know, me too. What face do you think he's gonna make? I think he's gonna be like,
No, I think he's gonna be like,
hey.
I had a bad dream.
Spiders?
Come on, kiddo. Back up. Okay, hop in.
Do you see how it's darker on that side of the room?
I do.
I dreamed that I fell asleep looking at the dark and spider's skin crawling out and ate me.
Oof, that does sound scary. But that was just a dream. There are no spiders here. See?
Can I sleep with the light on?
Why don't you sleep with the door open so that you can see the hall light?
But I can't see that light.
Why not?
I'll sleep on my left arm.
I have an idea. Hop out. Head here, toes here. I'm gonna wrap you up like a burrito. There you go. Here. Now you can see the light all night.
You'll leave the light on all night?
All night. Sleep well.
Hey, what are you still doing up?
Oh, that's on me. I needed her help cleaning.
Oh.
Didn't you see the stuff outside?
Yeah.
Okay, so what was your favorite? The goblins, the jack-o'-lanterns, or the cats? Were you scared?
You scared your dad speechless?
He didn't even notice. He never notices anything.
So...
I better go talk with her.
I'll hold on to your phone.
Oh, thanks.
So, how'd it go?
She's pretty mad at me.
Just wait till she's a teenager.
Don't say that. That's...
Coffee, unless you need something stronger.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for decorating with him. Sounds like you guys had a lot of fun.
We did. Oh. Not that it's any of my business, but, is that phone glued to your hand? Like, do you need to see a doctor?
Yeah.
I just have to make it through this presentation. If I can get through that, if it goes well, it'll free me up so I can spend more time with the kids. You know, quality time.
You know, my sister said that there's a Halloween party at the kids' school.
Halloween week,
it's a thing.
Okay.
Anyway, they have to bring homemade cookies, so maybe tomorrow night after work you could help us bake them.
I won't be home until late. I've got the dinner with a colleague.
I guess you could call her that.
Her, huh?
Yeah, to be honest, I'm not sure whether it's food with friends or an actual date.
Who suggested the dinner?
She did.
And what kind of food?
Italian.
Italian's probably a date.
Really?
Yeah, I've had my share of Italian restaurant dates. Most of them start with antipasta and end with me anti-everything. But all of this is research for this app that I've been working on.
Which would be?
Bad Dates and Broccolini.
I think I can get you financing for that.
Great. All right. Bye.
Thanks again.
Do you think my dad's in love with that Abigail person?
Abigail?
I saw her name in his phone. Leslie Mintz said that when her parents got divorced, her dad went out for dinner with a woman, and then 6 months later, they were married.
Cream, sugar. Mush the two together.
All right.
Nope, no measuring cups. I don't believe in measuring.
How do people know when they're in love?
You're asking me? I'm single.
Yeah, but you're like 40, right?
Last time you said I was 50.
You look younger the more I get to know you.
Let me know when I get to my 20s. We'll have a party.
Yeah. Do you think my dad's gonna fall in love with Abigail?
I wouldn't worry about that.
I'm not worried. I don't get how people know.
I think you know you're in love when you see something really beautiful and your first thought is, I want them to see it too. Or when they make you laugh. Or when you love what they love because they love it.
Have you ever been in love?
Like that? Not really. Not yet. Okay, crack some eggs.
Great.
Pick one.
I choose you.
Not that one. Just joking.
Well, they offered me an executive position with a full benefit package. Health plan, housing, expense account, all the perks. But I said no. I mean, it's a great promotion. I can't see myself living in Tokyo.
Well, that sounds like a tempting offer.
I'm kind of hoping I'll get a better offer here.
Listen, about the presentation, I feel like you should probably...
How about we don't talk about business tonight?
Okay. Actually, I wasn't really sure whether this was, you know, a work thing.
If it was a work thing, would I be flirting so shamelessly?
So you were flirting.
It wasn't obvious.
Still up?
Dad, come see. These are the best Halloween cookies ever.
Sorry, we got a little bit carried away. But these are not just Halloween cookies. These are educational cookies.
I see skeletons, bats, haunted houses. How is that educational?
This skeleton cookie? A celebration of science. There are 206 bones in the human body.
What about the bats?
Recently added to the endangered species list, a reminder of how important it is for us to care for our environment.
And the haunted houses?
Okay. These are kind of Halloween-ish, but I prefer to think of them as houses for the past.
Yeah, I don't know about that one, but...
Dad, will you come to the Halloween party tomorrow? Please, it's at lunch. You hardly have to miss work.
I will try my very best, sweetheart.
Yeah.
Okay, now, if you guys hurry and get your pajamas on, we'll have enough time for two bedtime stories, but that means you have to go now.
Yeah, let's go.
Go!
Go!
Come on, Zach, beat me upstairs.
So, when you say, I will try my best, does that really mean no?
Well, I've got a busy day tomorrow.
Okay, listen. When I was little, my parents split up, and my mom is this total free spirit. Like, she always has some new hobby she's passionate about. But she never came to my soccer games or my sister's choir recital. And then there was my dad, who was really hard to communicate with. He was this super stoic man, but he always showed up. Who do you think I'm closer to?
I will be there.
Good.
I'm really glad you're here. You got a little flower in your hair.
So, was it a date?
Turns out it was.
So, it might be date number two.
Maybe.
Cool. Good. Well, I will see you tomorrow at the Halloween party.
Great.
Okay.
Thanks again.
Yes, he's coming.
Even though he has no time for Halloween?
He's just forgotten how much fun it is, but we're gonna remind him.
right? Come on, help me pass out these cookies before I eat them all myself. Oh, thank you, sweetie. Here you go.
This is
perfect.
Wait, no. No, listen, it's got to work flawlessly on all platforms. Not just your phone. It's got to work on your laptop. It's got to work on your tablet. Any device available to you.
Ryan, they're waiting for you in the conference room.
It's not 11:30.
No, it's 11:45. I've been reminding you since 11.
Hey. No, listen, I got to call you back.
Where is he? He's probably stuck in traffic. No, he said he would be here. You're getting pretty involved here, aren't you? Me? No, I'm thinking about the kids. No, I'm not just talking about the kids. Don't do this again. Do you want to be an old maid? Old maid? Really? Like, who says old maid? Oh, you're right. Is spinster better? Spinster's better. I prefer spinster. Look, I've known Ryan since the boys were in kindergarten. He's a great guy. Yeah, he is. He's just... not for you. Dating someone else. Who? Her name is Abigail. They're colleagues. Oh, well, that doesn't sound like much of a threat. They eat Italian food together. Well, maybe a little bit more of a threat. She's pretty. Actually, she's gorgeous. Oh, you met her. Nah, I Googled her. It means nothing. I Google a lot of people. Okay, well, then I guess I can tell you. I have another blind date for you. Does he already have his wedding tuxedo picked out? Stop it. Does he live with his mother? You know, I'm gonna get back to you on that one. Hey, Zach. I think I saw your name on the mummy wrap.
Really?
Yeah. Zoe's over there. You wanna go check it out?
Yeah.
You know who else is gorgeous? You are. Okay, buddy. Let's see who can gift wrap a monster. Come on, guys. You can do it. You can mummy me better than that. Go crazy.
Go faster.
Faster, faster, faster. Go, 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 go. Oh, we got my phone.
Yeah. It's Dad. Is he here? No. It says, tell the kids I'm sorry, but I can't make it.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys. Have you ever seen The Creature from the Black Lagoon? It's about a creature. From a lagoon. Or we could watch The Wolfman, which is basically a parable for how scary dads look when they don't shave. Okay, I know he didn't show up, but I bet he had a really good reason.
He only cares about work.
That's not true. He loves you.
He loves work more. He's good at it.
I think I just got an idea of how we can get his attention. All right, you hold this, bring it upstairs. Come on, let's go.
Hey guys, what's all this?
Please have a seat.
So what's going on?
That's what we'd like to ask you.
Okay. I know I missed the party. Something came up at work, and I...
We're evaluating you in your capacity as father. Shall we begin? While my colleague and I feel it's clear that you love your children, your failure to meet them at their Halloween function...
Okay, well, you know, I got slammed and I'm not...
Please don't interrupt. Your failure to show up after you promised you would is just one example of an alarming trend in how you choose to be a father. From our perspective, you care about work and your cell phone and your computer and your cell phone. And then after all those other things, you care about your kids. And really, we should be first. Your priorities are out of work? Whack. Do you want to be the dad who breaks promises?
No, I do not. I don't.
Then don't be. in summation, you should probably make more of an effort in the dad department. Do you agree with our assessment?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Here are the results of your evaluation. Please review.
Brought to my attention that my priorities are way out of work. Let's see who can find the best pumpkin, huh?
Yes! Go for it, guys.
I can't remember the last time I looked at pumpkins.
Well, they're still orange.
What was it? Ferris Bueller once said life moves pretty fast if you don't stop and look around once in a while.
You might miss it.
Yeah.
He was a wise fictional teenager.
It's true, though. I missed a lot lately.
Well, you're here now.
Yeah, thanks to you. Promise me you won't make me dress up for Halloween.
Oh, I make no promises. In fact, I could see you dressed as a smartphone, like a really smart smartphone.
I take it you've got your costume?
Are you kidding? I haven't missed a Halloween since I was 2, which was 20 years ago.
Right.
I'm super young.
And Zoe told me you were 28.
Did she? Love her.
I'm 34, in case you were wondering.
Oh, I wasn't. I Googled you.
I Googled you.
Well, you had to. You're a techie. You Google everyone.
No, not everyone.
Oh, what about this one? For the front porch?
Yeah, I kind of like that one.
No, that one's like a pumpkin ate a pumpkin.
Hey, go big or go home.
How much do you think it weighs?
Hey, listen, just because I'm a techie doesn't mean I can't lift a pumpkin. I can't lift a pumpkin.
Okay, I'm gonna help you. I'm coming in. Oh, gosh, it's really heavy. Okay. I feel like you've got most of the weight on you.
I think I do.
How do I? Ready?
Yep.
Oh.
It feels squishy.
Oh, like worms.
Dad, gross.
Ooh, are you sure? I thought you loved eating worms.
No.
Get in there.
Dad.
Okay, let's talk costumes. Time to get serious.
All right.
I'm gonna be a witch.
Good witch or bad witch?
A good witch.
Good luck with that.
Dad.
What about you, buddy?
I'm gonna be a spider.
Really?
Poppy says the best way to get over your fears is to face them.
Well, I couldn't agree more. You're gonna make a great spider, bud.
I'm gonna scare everybody.
Except for yourself.
Hey, actually, you know, there's a costume shop near where I work. We could actually...
Oh, a costume shop? That's for amateurs. We're gonna make our costumes.
Really?
Yeah, my sister does it every year.
Wow. Okay.
Thanks for making our dad spend time with us.
Hey, I didn't make him do anything. You guys showed him what he was missing.
All right.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah?
After we're done carving pumpkins, can you make your special hammockers?
That's a great idea. You know, maybe Poppy can help with that.
You going back to work?
I've got a dinner thing.
With Abigail?
Yeah, how did you?
Italian again.
Hey, why don't we go to dinner? How's pizza sound?
Really?
Yeah, I know a great place downtown, and I think the manager likes me so we can get extra toppings.
All right, well, looks like you guys have things covered here. I'm gonna go head up and get ready.
Okay.
All right, let's finish carving these pumpkins.
I don't like this Abigail person.
Can't dislike someone you've never met.
But he's gonna marry her and she's gonna be your new mom.
Oh, it's only their second date. A lot has to happen between date number 2 and let's get married. Besides, no one could ever replace your mom.
But we don't like her. Yeah, we like you.
I like you guys too. But you can like more than one person.
You should marry our dad.
Who
here likes pineapple pizza.
Hey, our dad likes pineapple pizza. You could have that at your wedding.
And gummy worms.
You could have a gummy worm wedding cake.
You know who could perform the ceremony? This guy. Yeah. He'll be like, and I'll kiss the bride.
Well, I'm glad we can make it out today.
It's funny, I feel like I'm still getting used to the whole dating thing.
Yeah, that cologne tipped me off.
Too much?
Maybe a little.
Hopefully it won't dissipate by Halloween.
Well, I can wait.
To be honest, I haven't really dated since my wife died.
You know, I think it's really great that you're getting back out there. Yeah. Especially with me. I mean, you don't even have to worry about making a good first impression because I'm already impressed.
Likewise.
Let's have a look at us impressing each other. You okay?
Yeah. Actually, I think my kids are a little worried that I'm dating again.
They probably think I'm trying to replace their mom. You know, it's like in business. When one company takes over another, the employees are always worried they're going to be replaced with new staff.
Yeah.
Just don't think it has to be that way. We just need to show Zoe and Zach nobody is being replaced.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah.
Award-winning.
How was your date?
Not exactly award-winning, but it's okay, I guess.
Oh.
But she wants to go out again.
Oh.
So that's something.
That is something.
Is it?
Yeah.
So I'm not sure the kids are gonna like the idea.
Oh, I think that's really natural.
Yeah. Well, thanks again for everything.
You're welcome for everything. Oh, I was getting my keys.
Sorry, I saw you go in for the lean. I thought we were hugging.
Hug? That was a hug?
Well,
it's more sort of hug adjacent.
Yeah, she's okay. Right, we were friends. Friends hug.
Yeah. Hugs with Friends. Another new app.
There you go. I owe you again.
Okay. I'm just getting my bag.
Okay, I'll stay away.
Bye, friend.
Bye, friend.
Okay. Hugs with Friends.
It was the pinnacle of awkward.
Did you hug him back?
No, it wasn't romantic. It was a misunderstanding.
Well, everything happens for a reason.
Would you not make this into something it's not?
Because this is what you do, Poppy. You run when things get good.
Well, what if they're too good? It means they might end badly.
No, it doesn't have to.
See, this is complicated, Meg. Like, it's not just about me. Zach and Zoe want me to marry their dad. It's not fair for them to think that something might happen between Ryan and I when it can't.
And why can't it, exactly?
He's my boss,
temporarily.
He's on date number two with Abigail, and date number three is pending.
Oh.
And he asked me for dating advice.
Oh, again. You know, I couldn't ask for a better sister.
and butt.
Well, you've been here for me and the kids, and I appreciate every minute. Every dragon pillow fight and mac and cheese.
Where are you going with this?
You've committed to us, but we can't be the only commitment that you make.
Go down a little lower. A little lower. Lower. Good. Go!
This is awesome!
Glad you approve.
I do.
Question, do you think we need more decorations?
Absolutely. But then you would need a bigger house. Where are the youngins?
They're upstairs brushing their teeth.
You didn't.
What?
Candy for breakfast?
Oh, it's just one little piece. Cream, two sugars?
Black, one sugar.
If somebody came in here and saw us, they'd think we were some old married couple.
Old?
Super old.
How many decades have we been together?
3. We met...
on a blind date.
On a blind date, yes.
We had a small wedding.
A big wedding. And we honeymooned at Niagara Falls.
No, see, you thought it was Niagara Falls, but that's just because the toilet overflowed in the airport hotel when our flight was canceled.
I remember now, yes. And instead, we stayed up the whole night just listening to music. Oh, my. I do believe they're playing our song.
What a coincidence.
They say, one dance, for old time's sake.
How can I say no to that?
You can't.
Dad said he's gonna take us trick-or-treating on Halloween.
Nice try. I said Poppy will take you trick-or-treating and I'll try to get there at the end.
What time is the end again?
Well, whenever you guys are done and eating candy. And by the way, you better save me some.
Oh, we make no promises.
But we are making...
our costumes!
And we're gonna finish them today.
Whoa, impressive.
Poppy said she's gonna make these costumes really special for us.
I figured they haven't really done Halloween in a couple of years, so it's time to do it right. Go home or go big, right?
Is that right?
That's close enough. All right, guys, time for school. Hey, why don't we walk today?
But aren't you going to be late for work?
Well, I'm confronting my fears, too. Go on, go get your bags.
Race ya.
No, Bert, you got a head start. No, I didn't.
So you're gonna need to keep your geek speak to a minimum.
Is this your coded way of telling me to not talk about coding?
It wasn't exactly coded.
I will minimize my inner geek for the presentation.
Good. Have you ever been to Tokyo?
I barely have time to come here.
Well, after the presentation, which I know Higashimoto will love, we should go.
To Tokyo.
Yeah. Take the corporate jet, meet everyone. It's an amazing city. I mean, it's just like New York. No one ever sleeps. You got something in your schedule I don't know about?
I promised the kids I'd be home before dark.
Mm. Or you'll turn into a pumpkin.
There were pumpkins involved.
Mm. Higashimoto-san. Ohayou gozaimasu.
Mm-hmm. Oh, get it. Right here, right here. Down the street. Poppy!
Woo! Got it! Woo-hoo. Oh, get this.
This looks like a pretty serious game you guys got.
Dad, you're here!
Well, listen, it's not a real football game until the quarterback shows up.
Yeah, when does he get here?
Hey, how about you? What do you think, guys versus girls?
So on.
All right.
Over here.
No.
Yes.
Oh, come on.
Yes.
Slam! Uh-oh!
What? Oh, no! Come on! Oh.
It's not Jeff!
That's
not Jeff! Don't pile! Not Don't pile!
No way!
Coming Come in!
What are you tackling me for? We're on the same team!
Hello!
Oh. Everyone, this is, Abigail. Abigail, these are my kids.
Wow.
Zoe and Zach, right? It is so lovely to meet you both.
And, this is Poppy, my, our,
Nanny.
Nanny.
Nice you. To meet you, Abigail.
Likewise. Foreign analytics came in. I thought you'd want them. You didn't answer your phone.
Yeah, sorry. I was going for a 2-point conversion.
Poppy scored 3 touchdowns.
2 touchdowns. That last one does not count.
Of course it counts.
No way, no.
We'll talk about it later.
Okay. I gotta get back to work anyway, so. But you know, we could work here.
Oh. I suppose.
Then we can have dinner and, you know, we're making pumpkin pasta, pumpkin soup, pumpkin pie, pretty much anything pumpkin, right? I mean, if that's okay.
Oh, more the merrier. Thank you, Poppy. All right.
All right. Good game. Good game.
Yeah,
guys.
That was fun, Dad.
Okay, so, what's the latest?
Revision and that could work.
Oh, yeah. Oh, sorry, it's Zoe. Yeah. Now?
Everything okay?
Yeah, I'll just be a few minutes.
Okay.
Okay. Ready?
Open them.
You look amazing.
Beyond amazing.
I know. I mean, thank you. Now, introducing the spider from your worst nightmares.
Why?
I hate spiders.
Get out of here.
Put that spider in here. No, 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 no.
Hey, get in here. Group selfie.
Okay.
Here we go.
Wow, you kids look adorable.
So, how long have you been a nanny, Poppy?
Oh, a couple of weeks now.
Really?
Poppy's nephews go to school with the kids.
Oh.
Poppy's the best nanny ever. Nobody will ever replace her.
Zoe, flattery will get you everywhere. So, what did you do before this?
Poppy can do anything.
Again, that would be an exaggeration.
Poppy made our Halloween costumes. By hand.
That is very industrious. I do have to admit that spider costume was quite scary.
He's not afraid of spiders anymore. Poppy taught us how to face our fears.
You know, I had a costume when I was a kid. It was so cool. I think I probably wore it 4 Halloweens in a row.
What were you?
A knight.
In shining armor?
More like tinfoil.
My favorite costume was an astronaut.
Really?
Yeah. Oh.
What planets did you visit?
Well, I didn't actually leave Earth.
But you're an astronaut.
I think what Abigail's trying to say is that she went to so many planets that she couldn't keep track of all of them. Thank you, Poppy.
Yeah. So what was your favorite planet?
Pluto.
Pluto's not a planet anymore.
Actually, that's inaccurate, Zoe. Most experts say that Pluto is still a dwarf planet. It's in the Kuiper Belt.
Are you going to be an astronaut this year?
Mm. Your father and I have a presentation, so we're going to be wearing business clothes.
Yeah, it's a big day for us.
It's a big day for us, too. It's Halloween.
That's right, and I will be home right after we're done.
Oh, I hate to bring this up, but Higashimoto has asked us to be his dinner guests after the presentation.
Oh, is that necessary?
It would be considered an insult if we didn't.
Right. Okay.
So, now you're not even going to be there at all.
Hang on. Both? No, I got it.
Are you sure? Okay. It's funny. I talk with CEOs of companies in Japanese. Talking with kids is a whole different story.
Kids are like CEOs, except they're shorter and smarter.
You're really good with them.
Oh, you should have seen our first day together. They barely spoke to me. And I'm not even going to mention the hungry goat incident.
Goat.
Thing about kids is they're funny, sneaky, difficult, goofy, clever, competitive. I mean, they're kids, so there are lots of things, but they'll test you before they trust you.
All right. Crisis averted.
Oh, good. I will get them ready for bed.
Thank you.
Well, I should get going. We can finish this up tomorrow.
I'll walk you out.
Okay, let's build a fort. Okay.
So, I guess I'll see you tomorrow.
Bright and early.
Good night.
The very next day, poor Ichabod Crane did not appear at school. His horse was found wandering free.
And so, the Headless Horseman was never seen again. The end. So wait, it was really just a guy with a pumpkin on his head?
Or was he? All right, guys, bedtime.
I love you, Poppy. I love you, too.
Oh, I love you guys.
Hey. So, Endless Horseman rides again.
And again, Zach wanted to hear it twice. Good night.
Hey, can we talk?
About what?
Us.
You want to talk about us?
Yeah. Look, I know you were supposed to be, temporarily ours, but, everything's just changed so quickly. What I'm trying to say is,
You want me to stay on as your nanny?
Sure. Yes, but
the thing is, Ryan, the kids are getting attached to me, and I'm getting attached to them, and that was never supposed to happen.
Why not?
Because you guys are a great family, and Abigail's here, and I'm kind of in the way.
This is not how I pictured the conversation going.
I don't think this is for me.
What?
I'll stay through Halloween, but that's it.
Halloween?
I mean, that was the plan.
Yeah, well, plans change, you know? People change. They get attached. You know, my kids love you.
And I love them. But I don't think that this is going to work. I just don't...
You know what? I don't want to drag this out. If you want to leave, I think it's better you just do it now.
Fine. I will, I'll swing by in the morning and I'll say goodbye to the kids.
That's all right, I'll do it.
But only if you think that would be best for them.
I do.
Oh, well then, bye.
believe you quit.
Ugh, I didn't mean to. It just happened. He asked me to stay on as his nanny.
So?
Well, I may not know what I want, but I know what I don't want. And that's to get hurt.
Getting involved doesn't have to mean getting hurt. Come on, what happened to facing your fears?
That works for everyone but me,
Poppy.
I like him. I, like, really like him. But I saw him kissing Abigail, so I have to get over it.
Maybe it was a friend thing.
Are you kidding? There's no kisses with friends. That's not an app.
Yeah.
Where's Poppy?
I am going to be taking you to school today, and then afterwards you're going to go home with the Marshall kids.
And Poppy will pick us up from the Marshalls?
I am going to be picking you up, too.
You're not working?
No, I'm going to work from home today with Abigail.
But what about Poppy?
Look, guys, you know she wasn't going to stay here forever.
But why not? She said she loved us.
She does. Of course she loves you, too.
She loves you. I can tell. She talks about you all the time.
Okay. Look, I know this is confusing, and I'm sorry, but you still got me, right? And I'm gonna be here for you.
Thank you for joining me for what I like to call Mellow Frog. Namaste.
Namaste.
You came back.
Mrs. Clemmer, yes, I needed a little bit of yoga.
Yeah, well, that's good. I'm glad. But you were a million miles away.
Why do you say that?
Well, I raised four girls. I know what boy trouble looks like.
Is it that obvious?
So what did he do wrong?
No, nothing. It's more complicated than that.
Sounds like unfinished business to me, and that's the worst kind.
What do you mean?
It follows you around wherever you go, unless you do something about it. Listen to your heart, dear. Don't take too long, whatever you decide.
Which is why we're so happy to become part of the Yamaharo global family. May food with friends be just the beginning.
That's good.
We should add a line about how the app would strengthen the Yamaharo global brand, right? What's wrong?
It's too quiet up there.
Isn't that a good thing?
Not with my kids. I'll be right back.
Sure.
You guys okay?
When's Poppy coming back?
Zach, stop asking him. She's not coming back, okay? We'll just get another new nanny and then another. Dad will always be too busy for us. So just get used to it.
So? That's not gonna happen. Even though Poppy's not here anymore, things are not going back to the way they were. Okay?
Okay.
I know you guys miss Poppy. You know what? I miss her too.
Alright, snazzy backpack. There you go. Which one are you again?
Death Kid.
Happy Halloween, Aunt Poppy.
Happy Halloween, guys. I can't wait to see your costumes later.
Okay, guys. Today is the big day, huh?
The business presentation?
Well, and Halloween. Now, remember, Jean will be here to take you guys trick-or-treating, so make sure she gets lots and lots of photos.
And you'll take us next year, right?
You bet I will.
Who cares about next year?
He'll be like 100 by then.
That's true. But I will have a cane, so I'll be able to hobble alongside you guys.
Wait up for me!
Let's go. Don't want to be late. Come on.
What are you supposed to be?
Starfish.
Doesn't a starfish have more points?
I ran out of material.
Well, you look very aquatic.
Sure you don't want to come with us? We could leave the bowl out, but the please take one note.
I'm not going to risk letting some teenagers steal all the candy. I'm staying right here.
I'm fine. Okay. Boys, let's go!
Hurrah!
Bye, guys. Have so much fun. You look awesome.
Thanks, Aunt Poppy.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Okay, now hold still because these arms are difficult.
What is your costume?
A harried executive assistant. Okay. I think I've got it.
I think it's backwards.
Oh. Yeah. I knew that was too easy. Okay, let's go again. So, this is it.
Right, when Food with Friends goes global, this is really gonna open some doors for us.
Yeah.
And why aren't you thinking about any of that right now? Ryan, your kids will be fine, okay? It's just one Halloween. They're gonna benefit from your success. You know that, right?
Yeah, I do, but they don't. You know, it's just another night to them where their dad's working instead of home with them. Again. It wouldn't be so hard if I knew Poppy were with them, but...
I'm going to Japan, Ryan.
What?
That job offer in Tokyo? I said yes.
Okay.
I've seen you with Poppy. Your kids love her, and I'm pretty sure that you're falling in love with her, too. I'd be fooling myself if I didn't acknowledge what was going on between the two of you and graciously step aside. So, that's what I'm doing. I'm stepping aside.
Trick-or-treat!
Wow, look at you! Here you go. Don't be shy. No child left uncandied. Hey, look at all those crazy bones. And you, your makeup matches your braces.
Thank you.
Hi. Zoe? Zach? What are you doing here? I've been wanting to talk to you. Your costumes look amazing. Oh, I'm so sorry. Hi. I thought you were my friend Zoe and Zach. They're kind of about the same. Are you in Mrs. Green's second grade class? Anyway, you would totally love them. And their dad is the best guy I've ever met. He is kind and funny and totally for me. He's totally for me. He's for me. Here, take this. Okay. I have to go. Happy Halloween.
It is my pleasure to introduce to you Ryan Larson, a brilliant man who I know will be creating many more products for Yamaharo Global in the future. Ryan?
Thank you. First, I just want to say what an honor it is to be able to present this application to you all today. I created Food with Friends because I wanted social media to be more social. I wanted to really connect people face to face. So imagine if you could sit down with a complete stranger and form a bond. Maybe you find some common ground and make a new friend. Maybe it's just, a nice break in the day. It's funny. I've spent all my time lately working on this presentation because I really believe, we believe, that Food with Friends will connect people. But as a result, I've missed out on time with the people that I love most. Time I can't get back. So if you'll forgive me, I will now turn it over to the insightful and generous Abigail Morwell to tell you all about this amazing application. Thank you. Arigato. Sorry.
Okay. I got it from you.
I know you do.
Okay.
Knock 'em dead.
All right. Let me first thank Mr. Higashimoto and his associates for being here tonight.
I think I've got it. All right. I ain't afraid of no spider. Mm-mm.
Trick or treat.
Dad, you made it.
There's no way I was gonna miss out on going trick-or-treating with you guys. Thanks, Gene. I'll take it from here.
How'd it go with Global?
Oh, great. Abigail's wowing him as we speak.
Well, then, happy Halloween. Have fun, kids.
Thanks again.
Bye!
Okay, guys, listen up. I think I've got the perfect place to start trick-or-treating.
Yes. You're going to need a costume.
I'll be right back.
Human fish coming through.
10 eggs full of honey.
Well, how do I look?
You look great. What are you?
What do you mean? I'm a knight in shining. I'm your dad. Let's go.
We need our bags.
Oh, you know what? Get your pillowcases. They're bigger. Go, go, go.
Come on, Zach.
You're here.
You're here. What about your presentation?
This is my presentation. I got a tinfoil, I got a sword, a towel.
Suits you.
I was just going to find you.
You found me.
Poppy, we don't need a nanny. We just need you. I need you. Is permanently yours, son.
Well, I'm gonna need to make a new business card.
Yeah.
She's back. She really is a mermaid. She's our mermaid.